right here. Thank you, eh? Funny. Yeah.
Yeah, and obviously everyone remembers the first game of the season up at the Emirates. Thrilling game to watch. A lot of water's flowed under the bridge for both sides. How, in your mind, are the two teams to challenge?
Oh, I can't say too much about Arsenal. As it was the start, it's like it is in an idle world, free flowing start. Eh? So not perfectly organized and no bad experience together. As full of confidence as possible after a preseason, we were all convinced about that we did the right things. And did we have to? Probably the Barcelona game was not too long ago, so it was another nice game in London. So completely optimistic, that's how it is. And then a season is coming up, and meanwhile we have a few bad moments together, so that's how it is. So that of course changed, and it's not that it doesn't feel that free-flowing anymore, but that's how seasons are. So maybe only one team who has exactly the same feeling still, that's Chelsea, and all the rest is had better or worse moments in the season. And obviously we have this, meanwhile, this lack of consistency, we cannot ignore it, because we were involved in the games. So, and that's the thing we have to do now. So it's not too important to compare the start of the season with this moment, but it's obviously different. So that's how it always is. So if you want, you can always already looking forward to the start of the next season, because it will be the same feeling. Yeah. And whatever happens in this season. So that's the thing. But now we are now in the middle of the season, and we thought it makes sense when we try to deliver again on Saturday.
There's a meeting of the IFAB ongoing. One of the proposals being put forward is that perhaps only captains should be able to speak to the match official in order to increase discipline as a manager.
What?
The International Football Association board meeting, and one of the proposals being put forward is that during a game, only team captains should be able to speak to the referee. Mm-hmm.
I think that's already kind of a rule. When we are before the game in the refs' dressing room and introduce us in the rules and what he thinks about the game, it's always that he says to the captain, "Yes, and you can. If something is an issue in the game, then you can come to me and we can talk about it." So that's clear. But I think in a situation when a player, I don't know why players should talk to the ref, but it probably happens. So how we do it from the sideline, it happens. But I think it makes sense. But I thought it's already kind of a rule. How will you make it more strict? I have no idea. It's always yellow card. Then when one player is saying something, not sure that it makes too much sense. I thought that works pretty well in the moment. So from my side, no need for a rule change. But I'm not really in the. In the thing.
And just finally from me, on behalf of our friends at Sky Germany, they've been speaking to Dortmund today, revealed that Mario Götze hasn't been able to play due to metabolic disturbances. What's this, something you know? Have you been in touch with him? And what has he made of the injury, if you have?
Yes, we are in touch. We were always in touch with a lot of my former players. So in a situation like this, then of course we have exchange a little messages, but it's still. So he's. What can I say? Now he knows the diagnosis, and now you have to work on it and with it, and that's what he's doing in the moment. That's nothing else to say about. So it's of course when we have messages, then it's private, and nothing for public. But how with. Yeah, not all, but a lot of my former players, I'm still in contact, and then we talk about things like this, yes.
Thank you, Simon. Just something that you mentioned there, I know sometimes it gets lost in translation. So you were talking about optimism and confidence at the start of the season. I know it feels quite different now, maybe. Is that because that's not something I would assume from you, that you wouldn't be anything other than confident and optimistic? So is there something different?
Look, I'm not a clown, eh? Even when few people think I am. So I'm not always laughing like crazy. I'm not always, I'm a complete, I said it, a normal person. So it means we all are influenced by the experience we make. So that's how it is. And how should I be in exactly the same mood when I was in the beginning of the season? This is work now. But my job is that the players feel until the next game that there's a big chance that we can win it. And of course, but that's not with laughing the whole week and ignoring the problems you have. But the only thing I described was at the beginning of the season, the season starts. It's the first impression you get. And the first impression of this season was spectacular. Well, it was a wonderful game. Not the best start in the game. And we bounced back in the game. We scored fantastic goals. We were already through. Then we made it a little bit exciting again. So that was maybe a few people will say that's a little bit like the season, all in one game. But that was not clear in this moment that it could happen. We were really happy that we could beat a really strong side like Arsenal in their home ground. And the last games we played against them were always kind of spectacular. The home game last year here was intense and spectacular game. So maybe the next one will be similar. But we have only to think about how we can use experience from last game, experience from the game before, the Tottenham game, and all this stuff for this game. That's how our work is, because we cannot ignore the things that happen around, that's all. But I'm 100% optimistic again when I think about the Arsenal game on Saturday. But I cannot say that I'm exactly in the same mood than I was in the beginning of the season.
And you've mentioned goals. This competition, the match-up always seems to bring that number of goals for whatever reason. The one at the Emirates, Philippe and Roberto scored both the goals. Are they doing as much as you would like them to at the moment? Are they at that level that they were maybe back then? They're doing what you want
to. Phil and Roberto.
Firmino and
Okay. In the Tottenham game, yes. In the Leicester game, no. Pretty simple. So that's how it is. And it's not about I said it, and because it's the truth. The Leicester game was in this specific way special. There were really a lot of bad individual performances. That was the problem. If you have that many players not on their usual level, and each Premier League game will be difficult, especially this game was then difficult. And so we lost because of our performance. And that's all. So, but it's a week ago. And we have to do better, 100%. Not only Phil and Roberto, there were a few other players who have a lot of space to improve from this game. But how I said, it was not last year that we played really good. So we have to use the one thing, and if you want, and to use the other thing, and to go confident as possible in this game. And for this, it's Anfield, it's our stadium. We have the last game we played here was outstanding good, was fantastic actually. And so we want to have this feeling again, and for this, that's what we're working for.
All teams play well and play badly in this season, and you've already indicated that. We know that. Was the worrying part of the game against Leicester how passive Liverpool were, and where did that come from? Because we're not used to seeing that from Liverpool. And what can you guard? What can you do to guard against it happening again?
Oh, work on a pitch. That's how that's the life of a football coach and manager. So that's how it is. So we talk about the things. We work on it on the pitch and all that stuff. So, but I know, and I said it a few times, and we have to prove again. So. Unfortunately, because we were not good, and it was not to expect before the game that we will be that bad in the game against Leicester. So, but there are a lot of reasons why we played that bad, and that's the thing. It's not being passive. I don't know. It starts with a set piece for the long ball. Jamie Vardy had a second ball foul on Sadio, or probably after game everybody saw, but throw in for them, first throw in, and difficult. It's difficult. You can, whatever you have, a kind of plan you have to avoid these balls against Leicester, because when you let them throw the balls in the 6-yard box, that's a few of them are dangerous. So, and obviously they felt immediately in this moment, yes, that's what we want, and obviously we felt the opposite. We watched now analyze, of course, the game against the Leicester game against Man City. That looked a little bit not similar, but it looked like City was surprised. But in this moment, that's possible. But we couldn't be surprised because we knew about the City game and we knew about the situation that which changed at Leicester. But even then, we didn't perform. That's the truth. Sometimes, as a manager, you have to accept these things because you cannot change it. In the game, obviously, we tried everything, again, with system change, halftime, blah, 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 clear words, and what we have to do. We didn't talk a lot about the first half because that was already, the first half was already in the bin. So we have now to, we thought about the second half. And there would have been a lot of opportunities for us, which we couldn't use because, again, of the performance. It was a little bit better, but not good enough. That's all. I understand 100% that you all ask about this, but actually we made the analyze already, and for me it's already gone. I cannot keep it the whole week in my backpack and still I and Leicester, don't forget. So it's now Arsenal, and we had a few sessions, important sessions, which we prepared the Arsenal game, which is from the whole style of play and a lot of things, it's completely different. So yeah, you need to know about this, and you need to try to make it as difficult as possible for Arsenal to get something here, and that's the job to do.
It is Arsenal this weekend. Your record against the top six clubs is better than anybody's, and that gives you a real opportunity to say to the players, have you just been rousing them along this week to say, listen, come on, give me what you know you're capable of?
No, because I think it's obvious that I didn't use these words, because I don't like to talk about things like it's clear. No game against the top flight, top team of the league was easy. Not one of them. It was always hard work, was highest intensity and all that stuff. But we were until now always ready to really perform. That's what we have to do, but not because we did against the other teams, only because Arsenal is here. It's a good football playing side, and we need to bounce back. We need to get the points, to keep the points at Anfield. That's it. Not because we played. We cannot use the Arsenal of the first Arsenal game, because it's really a lot of water under the bridge, I don't use usually the games against similar teams. It's the real preparation for this game, the specific Arsenal game, and for this you use pictures from the last 3-4 games of Arsenal and not from the longer past.
Carl,
how much do you expect players when on the pitch to recognise that things are going wrong, react to it and influence things? Because on against Leicester it didn't seem like, as you said there, they seemed to recognise what was happening, what Leicester were doing to them.
Different things, so it's obviously, but what do you expect? What do I want? What do I want is that we delete the last situation, start new, and come on, so that we strike back. That's what you want. But actually, I saw a lot of times in my life, and even when I was involved as a player, and I was a real mentality player, so because I was not that good as a footballer, so my strength was pushing a few teammates and all that stuff. But even for me, it was not always possible. So that's the situation. And that's how I said, then you try everything in the game, to have influence from the sideline, to give the right information that they can help each other and all that stuff. But at the end, we had to accept it didn't work. It didn't work out in this game. So, but of course, in an ideal world, if the start is not good, yeah, then you start a little bit later and then you are at spot on and at 100%. But it's not easy, so that's why it makes sense to be spot on from the first second, and that's what we try again on Saturday.
You're obviously without Jordan, your captain against Leicester, so who's pushing those players, their teammates, in that situation when you're not really a captain who's weakening them?
we have these players, they do it always in different ways. Of course, Adam, of course, Milly, of course, Lucas Leiva, that's always these three players for sure. And with different things, usually Roberto Firmino with his attitude, readiness, so you can give him always the ball. But in this game, the first ball jumped 5 yards away from his foot. What's that? So it started like this and didn't get better in the game. So he couldn't obviously find a way back for a really good performance. But that, especially in this case, I have to say, okay, I don't know when it was last time. So what should I do now? That's a very good example. Go on him and tell him, did you see it? How can you do it? And all that stuff. It's over. That's the only good thing. It's done, and now we have the chance to make it much better. But we have the players, and it's always like this. When you play bad, then this question comes up. If you play well, nobody asks for the player who pushed the team. That's how it is. So all good, but that was not the reason for not performing.
Yeah, you get into team. You said the team haven't been physical enough. That's probably a problem that's been at Liverpool for 2 or 3 years, to just the odd game that comes up with. That's an issue. As a coach, can you help players become physical or does that have to come from within?
I think we were. You thought we had this problem, not being physical enough, but very often in this season?
There's probably a series of games going back a few years where you'd say it's Aston Villa in the semi final. It's been so much we cared.
Aston Villa in the semi final was when?
2015.
We were not physical enough in Aston Villa. No, I want to only try to understand. So, okay, it's not usual for us. Actually, I think we are clear, clean, not ugly challenges or whatever, but really physical. So, can you imagine that we run in the game, and now in this game 121 kilometers? I was really surprised because I thought that was the best example for running. Obviously, 80% the wrong ways, because 121 kilometers in this game, he played really bad performance. So that's physical, of course. I thought in the challenges, in the specific challenges, not harder, not making foul or something, being close enough, being there, being ready for all that stuff. I'm not sure if physical was the 100% right word, but it's not a general problem of us. It wasn't until now. So
just as an illustration, with 5 games you lost, only 3 players being up for fouls. I'm not saying you want your team to make dirty challenges, but is that showing you more physicality?
In the 5 games we lost, we had only 3 yellow cards.
3 yellow cards for fouls.
In my opinion, playing foul is not being physical, more being kind of doesn't help usually. There are a few fouls, tactical fouls, what you need sometimes. That's why you usually get booked for it. But being harder than allowed, don't think it makes sense. So I've never forced my players for playing foul, actually. So that's we are always pretty fair. We had always pretty fair teams, so because I think we want even a challenge. We want to keep win the ball, not to break a leg. So that makes hopefully sense. Again, when you lose, then that's completely normal that you ask for this. But being physical means being ready, or being this legal aggressive means being ready to hurt yourself, not the other player. So it's not that I'm in doubt about. But in this game, a lot of things came together, and that's why it was so bad. So, but how I said again, I know it's right to ask for it, but I can't ignore the game against Tottenham, which is 3 weeks ago, but pretty much the same player which played there, and they did really well. And now in this game they didn't. So should we doubt them in general? I don't think so. But we have to react because we live in the Premier League, and we have to deliver every week, each week, not only sometimes. And being consistent is the most important thing in life when you have the quality to reach something, because being inconsistent always lets you struggle, and that's the problem, and we have to work on it, and that's what we do.
For sure. Yeah, again, just stage of life, is it going to be too soon for him?
Yeah, well, John is too soon for sure. That will take time, and Dejan, we will see. He trained, yes. part of team training the day before yesterday. Yesterday, full team training. Well, now we have to see how he reacts on this, and he will be involved in training. If nothing, if nobody tells me anything different in training again, and then we have to make a decision. So that's it. It's not the longest. He was out pretty much for 4 weeks, training 3 days. At the end, I have to make a decision. I'm not sure about it.
Anything?
Yes, you said part of the issue at Leicester was so many poor individual performances, and in the summer with the recruitment, you spoke a lot about competition for places. Right now, currently, do you feel there's not enough? That's something that needs to be rectified, because you know the players often do play very well, but when they don't, there's no real pressure for a lot of them that they're going to lose their place to someone else because there isn't really anyone pushing them.
Do I really believe in putting people under pressure to perform on the highest level? No, it's always. But having a when I speak about the competition, I don't really thought about that they put them under this kind of pressure. I only think because of the quality of another player, you have to deliver I have to tell it, because so if I don't perform, then he can. So that's how it is. We had a few injuries, too much, 100%. Yeah, and that's it. We have not a lot of opportunities to change. And if you win, it's easier to change things than if you lose. Because to put the responsibility, so the players who played Leicester, if I say now, okay, come on, we change it now on 3, 4, 5 positions, what would be still possible, then I take them out of responsibility and I put it on the shoulder of other players and say, come on, let me see if you can do it. So, so it's always good to have the choice, because then you can react on shape and form and all that stuff, what you see and saw in training. In this moment we don't have that big choice on a few positions, not because the player were not there, but different reasons. So, for example, Ragnar Klavan was really ill, I said it already. Then that why Luke played against Tottenham, and he played outstanding good against Tottenham, made a really good game. So after Leicester, I think, Matt sometimes prepares me a little bit for the press conference, said, number six, maybe they will ask because number six is playing on centre half. But the answer could be because he did it really well in a lot of games, and it makes sense. Yes, did you perform outstanding good against Leicester? No, he didn't. So that's the situation. I always reason for it. It's not that I have that I don't want to change or things like this, but a week is not very long, but it's long enough to have different things when the medical department comes in and you know, okay, now he cannot train and he's a little bit ill and he's dead. So that's what we have to react on. No excuse. The players were absolutely fit on the pitch against Leicester, but we didn't perform. So, but I thought we try again.
Is Dan Sturridge back to training?
No. No. Daniel was ill, really, really ill again too. And now he has a strain in the hip muscle. It happened in the rehab session, and now it's not the biggest one. It's very small, but keeps him out of normal training for probably another week. And but in this week he can already train, but not team training.
Thanks, guys.
Welcome.